Hi everybody, Jillian here to share a brand new Bible journaling process video with you using the September Faith Art Box from Creative Retreat. So this was my entry that I completed a couple weeks ago in Ephesians, and I was very much inspired by the devotional by Ashley, which is the subscriber exclusive for this month. I wanted to do a follow-up for this entry today. And so the last prompt included here in her devotional content says, reflect and journal about what you experienced. And I want to do just that in my Bible today. The verse that I want to journal is actually on the back side of this page, and you'll see there's already an entry there. And so I'm going to go ahead and use this space over here to the right in Ephesians 6 to journal Ephesians 5 verses 1 and 2. I've got the leftover parts of my kit right here, as well as the enamel shapes that are in the shop. I want to make sure to use these because they're so fun. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and put you guys on fast forward and get started.
So as you can see, I have an entry on the back side of this page too, and you can see a little bit of shadow from the pen that I used to get my journaling down. You can see the shadow from the stickers that I outlined on the back, and then I had done some stamping using Faber-Castell markers as the ink. And so while it didn't create any bleed through, there is some significant shadow, and I want to go ahead and cover that up with some white acrylic paint. And so I just very quickly and easily used the card swiping technique to get some white, just really inexpensive big box acrylic paint down on the page. I didn't go over the text too much, and if I did, it didn't totally obscure it and you could still read it. This is as much as I'll ever prep a page ever. I've never been one to use gesso, and so this is just something that I like to do when there's a little bit of shadow or even bleed through on my pages. I just kind of deal with it when I journal the backside of that page. And so I'm going to hit that with my heat tool to help speed up the drying process. And then I just wanted to get really messy with this entry since I already had the paint out and decided to grab some watercolors. And I'm going to do some black paint splatters, but I want it to be kind of layered into the entry instead of the finishing touch on top. So that's why I'm using this black watercolor to get some paint splatters down now. And then that aqua colored ink pad that's sitting there off there to the right is going to come into play very soon here. So I'm just hitting this with my heat tool one more time to make sure that it's totally dry. You could see me turn my sticker sheets over from my kit to use those as a mask to protect my work surface so I didn't get any black paint all over the place. Next, I'm going to get started on my title using the alpha stickers. Remember, peel these up very carefully. They're pretty fragile and I wouldn't want them to rip on you. And so, like I said, I am journaling Ephesians 5 verses 1 and 2, which say, follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. The fourth word there is therefore. So we got to ask ourselves, what's it there for? So I'm going to go back up to chapter 4, verses 31 and 32, which say, get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. And then it goes on to say, follow God's example, therefore. And the main thing that I wanted to pull out of this verse is the beginning of verse 2 where it says, and walk in the way of love. And so we used the alpha stickers to get the walk word down. I used the red label, as you can see there, just to handwrite those smaller words in the way of. And then I love this love stamp. It's probably my favorite part of the kit, and I wanted to use that a bunch on today's entry, and that's just what I'm going to do. So I'm going to stamp the word love all over the page, but I don't want to stamp over the title I just put down, so I'm creating a mask here. And I thought maybe I could use my 2-inch circle punch to punch out a piece of scrap paper and cover it, but that just wasn't going to work. So then I decided to grab a ramekin, a kitchen ramekin that I store craft supplies in, and I traced around that on some scrap paper. I cut it out very wonky and lightly washi taped it down so that I'm covering the title I just put down, and so I don't get aqua ink all over the place. Now, I really liked using this color. It went pretty well with the colors in the kit, but it also doesn't cry out for too much attention on the page. So it kind of like fades into the background as a really nice layer with the white acrylic paint and the black paint splatter. The focal point of the entry is going to be the title that is currently masked. And then because this word love is in the same color, and it just kind of looks like a repeating thing, and so it's not taking up too much visual weight on the page. If that makes any sense. I decided here to go ahead and outline the circle. I'm just using a black precision pen here to do that, and then thought maybe I only want to do it partially, and then decided to go ahead and just do the whole thing. I had put down one cardstock sticker, the heart with the arrow through it, because I wanted to indicate that the verse was on the adjacent page, and so you're going to see that move a few times, but in the meantime here, I'm going to go ahead and finish writing out the verse. I had a little bit of white space left in the circle template that I used because it was larger than the title that I had created. I decided to just pull the scripture over from the left side and get it down in the margin here. And I didn't fit both verses down totally, but I got the meat of them. And then to fill in a little more white space, I'm going to go ahead and put in these beloved Creative Retreat wonky hearts. And as I was doing this and putting these stickers down and picking them back up, I was kind of just chuckling to myself, like, I'm going to have to explain why I chose each one of these and kept putting them down and then changing it, and that's what was going through my mind as I was creating this. All in all, this entry only took about 24 minutes to do. And edited it down to this for you to share with you guys. Once I had all the stickers down, I realized I wanted to use the enamel shapes, and so I'm going to go ahead and use the lightest color aqua here just to kind of double up on some of the heart shapes. And then I decided, instead of using the cardstock heart with the arrow through it, to just go ahead and use the stamp. I wanted to bring a little more black into the page, and had actually thought about outlining the word walk, but forgot in the end, so I'll probably go back and do that off camera. I wanted to add a bow clip to this and thought the aqua one or the teal one was the perfect companion for it, and wanted to see how it looked behind the original entry. And then I'm going to go ahead and get my date stamp on the page. I actually inked it up and dropped it on my page, but you can't tell. And that's it. Here's a finished look at the entry along with a couple of close-ups. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're interested in checking out the September Faith Art Box, I've got it linked in the video description below.